It's 9:15 in the evening. She just had her son and his girlfriend come over. God, and now they're in the kitchen making all sorts of noise. Oh, he brought her beer. Fuck. Bullshit.
Shut up, bitch!
She's talking to the dog. Yep, there's the girlfriend. The dog pooped in a room again. Ridiculous. Jesus fucking Christ.
Thank you.
Listen to this noise. This is what I mean. This is why I'm not going to be able to hold a job if I ever get a job again. They're over here listening to fucking loud music and she's over in her bedroom yelling. She don't ever want to do anything for herself. I guess from what she was saying, or they're talking, they're yelling, that young Rick got a job day before yesterday. He worked yesterday, or he missed a day of work, and she's yelling at him, "You already missed a work. It's okay. I'm training." Kind of reminds me from that scene in the movie Friday. How can you get fired on your day off? Yeah, she's pretty sick. It's been, 2 weeks now? Yeah, this is never going to stop until someone gets killed or seriously hurt here. And I just texted the landlord on this. I don't expect to hear anything. But at least I did my part. Total madness. Fuck. Now they're having a wrap off. Every time that kid comes over, they just. My experience in being homeless and being around drug addicts and codependents, they never want to seek medical help, go to the emergency room, because of the one thing that they fear is that they fear of getting their blood tested to show proof that they're on drugs or whatever. And the greatest fear is that they have is that maybe the police might be called upon them. in this case, it's the same experience that I've experienced. That's why she doesn't call for help or go to the doctors or even the ER. Self-pride. So she'd rather die.